Ellen DeGeneres show is facing new allegations this morning of rampant sexual misconduct and harassment in the workplace. The new accusations reported by BuzzFeed News come just 2 weeks after another article on the site detailing a racist and toxic work environment. DeGeneres responded Thursday before the new article was published, apologizing and taking responsibility for what happens at the show. Warner Media is also conducting its own internal investigation. Jamie Yukis has more on the allegations.
Dozens of former staffers of the Ellen DeGeneres Show, which is known for promoting kindness.
When I say be kind to one another, I really mean it.
Are sharing new details about alleged inappropriate behavior behind the scenes by senior managers. Christy Yandoli with BuzzFeed News broke the story.
So former employees who worked on the Ellen Show told me that they experienced a range of sexual harassment and misconduct and witnessed a range of it, from sexually explicit comments to behavior and inappropriate, unwanted advances.
Before the article's release Thursday night, the show was already facing scrutiny after several former staffers described a culture of racism, fear, and intimidation in an earlier BuzzFeed article. Employees told the publication they were fired after taking medical leave or bereavement days to attend family funerals. Another former employee said she walked off the job after becoming fed up with comments about her race.
She said a head writer came up to her at a party and said, "Oh, I only know the names of the white people who work here."
In a letter to her staff, obtained by CBS News Thursday, DeGeneres said she'd hoped the show would be a place of happiness, where everyone would be treated with respect, and was disappointed to learn that this has not been the case.
I've spoken to nearly 50 former employees who worked on The Ellen Show. All of them say they found what their experience was behind the scenes to be in contrast to what the show makes a profit off of and what Ellen DeGeneres has built an entire brand off of, which is the be kind message.
We reached out to Warner Media and the show about the new allegations. Both declined to comment. Warner Media sent a statement before the article was published saying it was disappointed that the primary findings and its own investigation indicated some deficiencies related to the show's day-to-day management. It said it will implement several staffing changes to address the issues that were raised. Jerika.
Jamie, thank you.
You, with your words like knives and swords and weapons that you use against me. You have knocked me off my feet again, got me feeling like a nothing. You, with your voice like nails on a chalkboard, calling me out when I'm wounded. You, picking on the weaker man. You can take me down with just one single blow. You don't know what you don't know. Someday I'll be living in a big old city, and all you're ever gonna be is mean. Someday I'll be big enough so you can't hit me, and all you're ever gonna be is mean. Why you gotta be so mean?